Studies have shown that as many as 1 out of 4 college students may experience some form of sexual harassment or sexual misconduct on a college campus. Odds are that someone you know will or has already experienced some form of sexual assault or sexual misconduct on campus. If this is the case, the Office of Inclusion and Institutional Equity and our Title IX office are here to provide support.
Notices me.
He watches you in class. Go talk to him.
I don't think I'm his type.
Oh, here's your chance.
Hi.
Sean?
Yeah, it's Drea, right?
And this is Taylor. Hi.
Can you refill your drinks?
Sure.
Where's Taylor?
Beats me. She's not texting me back.
Everyone, get settled. We have several presentations to cover today. First up, Drea and Taylor.
Taylor's not here, Professor.
Well, you can choose to go next class, but I'm gonna have to take off some points. What's the deal?
I overslept.
We lost points, Taylor.
I'm sorry, I was just really tired.
Look, if I have to retake history just because you hooked up with some guy, you can at least tell me the details.
I'll be there next class.
You know you're my girl, right?
Just stop asking, okay? Just pretend Sean and I never happened.
Why?
I just didn't have a good time with him. It's just wrong. Promise you won't say anything? Promise?
Yeah, I guess. I promise.
Survivors of sexual violence respond in all kinds of different ways. For some students, reporting to the Title IX office can feel empowering, can feel like an important part of their healing journey. For other students, it can feel intrusive. It may even be re-traumatizing. If you're struggling with trying to figure out whether it would make sense for you personally to file a report or not with Title IX, the Counseling Center can help you talk that through and figure out what's best for you.
Looks like you might be getting stood up again.
You okay?
Drea and Taylor, since you're both here today, let's start class with your report.
So it was President Kennedy's determination to win the space race that led us to the moon landing. And now, Taylor will tell you about the math and engineering that made the moon landing possible.
Imagine you are trying to land on a moving target that's,
240,000 miles away.
200 and now. I can't do this.
Sorry. Taylor?
can't pretend like nothing happened.
What happened?
I went back to his place. And when I decided no, he kept touching me. I said no, and he kept going.
Are you saying Sean assaulted you? Taylor, you have to report this.
No, I don't want it in public. Most assaulters get away with it.
And if you don't report it, he will.
I can't be in class with him.
How about you tell Professor Jones about what happened with Sean? She'll listen. Professor? May we have a word with you?
Of course. Go ahead. I'm listening.
Please, Taylor. Can I pass this course without having to be here in class?
Not if I don't know the reason why. Taylor, you walked out mid-presentation. If something's getting in the way of your studies, there are a lot of options here on campus for you to get support. You can talk to me. I'm here for you. However, I must let you know I'm required to report any Title IX violation, if that's what comes up.
Okay. Thank you, Professor. Let's go, Drea.
Towson University's faculty and staff are deemed responsible employees, which means that if any of our faculty or our staff have knowledge of any incident of sexual harassment or sexual misconduct, they must report it to the Title IX office. There are some faculty and staff that are deemed mandated reporters pursuant to the Title IX regulations. Those mandated reporters are what we call campus security authorities. They are mandated by federal law to report, as opposed to responsible employees who are mandated by policy.
So why didn't you tell her?
It's up to me, not you.
So you're just gonna let him get away with it?
Hey, Taylor, wait up. What gives? You've been weird ever since the party.
I don't want to talk to you.
Can we have a moment alone, please?
Not after what you did to her.
What did I do?
You sexually assaulted her, Sean.
That's a lie.
Is it? I said no when you kept going.
That word never came out of your mouth. You were there. You saw how into me she was.
I saw some pictures. And even if she was into you, so what? No means no.
Oh, yeah? Do you see this picture?
She wasn't there.
You're right. She wasn't. And I didn't do anything.
You stay away from me.
She's lying, Drea.
Believe him, don't you?
No, I believe you. But that picture. Please report this.
You keep away from me too.
What? I believe you.
If you were my friend, then you wouldn't tell me what to do. Just don't ever talk to me again.
Taylor!
Drea, they can hear you typing all the way in periodicals. This is a library.
Sorry, TJ. I just have to be prepared to do Taylor's part now, too.
Did you two get in a fight?
You have to swear not to tell anyone this.
Do you have any idea how many secrets I keep?
Taylor is mad at me for telling her to report that Sean sexually assaulted her.
Whoa. Drea, this isn't about you. This is about the survivor.
Okay, TJ, no offense, but you're not an expert.
No, actually, I'm a SAPE, a sexual assault peer educator. I became one after an ex shared naked photos of me. These things happen a lot more often than you might think. And before you judge Taylor, try putting yourself in her shoes.
A SAPE is a sexual assault prevention educator, and we are students who collaborate and curate different events across the campus. These events are centered in sexual assault prevention, healthy communication, and consent. And we present them across the campus community, whether that's to a specific classroom that has requested it, a club or organization has requested it, or we're just putting on an open event. The students who attend the events are more than encouraged to come and speak to the educators after the event is finished and ask any questions they may have. If they want to disclose any act of sexual violence to the peer educators, they are more than welcome to do so, as we are not mandated reporters and we are trained on how to properly handle those hard questions.
Taylor, it's me. I know you don't want to talk to me right now, but I brought some things that could help. I'm gonna leave some stuff about campus resources, okay?
Pick those up. I don't want them.
What's going on?
I'm going back home.
You're leaving?
I don't want to be reminded of it every day, in every class. Here, take this. Remember me by it.
He took away your decision making, and I did the same thing by pushing you. I see that now. And for that, I am so sorry, because you are my best friend through good times and bad. I take you seriously as a survivor, Taylor. But it took something else besides engineering. It took courage. Consider what those first astronauts were facing as they launched into the great unknown.
Remember, the most important thing right now is that you feel safe. Everything you say here is kept confidential. And Taylor, when you're ready, the Title IX office is where you can file your report. And they'll help you get back on track academically.
They didn't know if the mission would fail, but they launched anyway. Not without fear, but with the courage to overcome it. Thank you.
Survivors of sexual violence can experience many unexpected reactions, both physically and emotionally. The Counseling Center is here to help survivors better understand and manage those emotions and reactions. One of the most important things that we offer are same-day appointments. So students who want to be seen at the Counseling Center can give us a call or can go online to set up an appointment and be seen the very same day that they decide they want to talk to a counselor. We also offer 24/7 crisis support. So after hours, if you want to talk to a counselor, you can call our main number and you'll be connected to a counselor who can help you deal with whatever crisis experience you may be having. The Health Center offers no-cost appointments for students who have experienced sexual violence.
Great presentation, Drea.
Thanks.
Looks like you two have something to talk about.
So, how'd it go?
Yeah, I think I'm ready. Walk with me.
Thank you.
So, I was thinking, what if I became a SAPE?
You?
Yes, me.
Well, I guess you did help me get here.
Hi, Taylor?
Yes, that's me.
Hi, I'm Erica. I'm one of the Title IX investigators here on campus. You wanted to see someone?
Yes. I'd like to make a report about something that happened to me.
Okay, come on back so we can meet privately. It takes courage, and you're not alone.
It takes courage, and you are not alone.
It takes courage, and you are not alone.
It takes courage, and we support you.